And remember, if you've got any problems, just come to me and we'll talk them over.
Sure.
In fact, why don't we talk them over dinner one night?
Yeah, I'd like that.
It's going to be all right, isn't it, Mr. Fletcher?
Yeah, I suppose so, Lizzie. It's only you come back to visit.
Oh, don't you worry, Mr. Fletcher. This time I'm not going to make any mistakes. This time, I'm out for keeps.
G'day, Mrs. M. Hope you didn't think I was trying to escape.
You don't look like an escapee to me, Lizzie. Anyway, I know you're better at it than this.
Of course I am. There isn't a prison that could hold old Lizzie Birdsworth.
Came to pick you up.
Oh, that's good. I didn't fancy being on me Pat Malone on me first day out.
I'm only sorry I didn't get there in enough time to pick you up at the door.
Oh, that's all right. It gave me a chance to say cheerio. I'm going to miss all my old mates, though, B, Dor and all of them.
Now, come on, Lizzie. None of that. Let's get you home.
Oh, yeah.
The screw's putting them two on the same block.
Oh, I don't know. We might see a bit of action. Something like that would really liven up my life at the moment.
Right. Join the line. When you've finished, you'll report to the laundry. Keep an eye on Goldman and Hennessy. Now, if either makes a move, send Hennessy out.
Right.
Here.
You may as well sit with me.
Reckon it won't be long now.
Screws are watching pretty close.
Well, so what? When she snaps, she won't care who's watching.
So long since I had a key of my own, I've forgotten how to use it. Oh.
Welcome home, Lizzie.
Home? God, that sounds funny. Oh.
Struth, look at this. Nanny cleaned it the other day. I'm going to have a job keeping it the way Sid liked it.
Oh, you can do it.
Those windows need cleaning. The cobwebs on the ceiling. Where do they come from? Oh. Oh, what a shame. My maiden hair didn't get enough water. Oh. You know, Mrs. Sam, I'm going to love this place.
Well, as long as I get a nice cuppa every time I come to visit.
And scones. I'm real hot stuff at the Devonshires, you know. Oh. I love this place. And the garden, even though there is a screw over the fence.
She's just like a neighbour now, not an officer.
Yeah, I know, I used to like her, but she's gone a bit funny since old Vinegar went to Barnhurst.
Well, I suppose I should be going.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mrs. M. Here's me chirping on about nothing. Oh, thank you very much for coming. And there's no need to worry about me, and I'm going to be so happy here.
Yes, you'll be fine. Actually, I think Sid'd be very proud of you if he could see you now.
Do you want to know something? I don't know whether you'll believe in this, but Sid's here in this house. He's here.
Come on, walk me to the car. hope you're not going to stay in the house all the time.
Oh, no, Mrs. M. I'm going to get working in the garden as soon as possible.
No, that's not what I meant. I meant it's time you made some new friends.
Oh, well, that'll be a bit hard. The last 20 years, all my mates have been inside.
Well, now's the time to make some new contacts. Well, the bowling club's not far away.
Or the pub.
No, come on, Lizzie. Oh, that reminds me. I've got a housewarming present for you.
Have you?
Well, it's not really for the house.
Oh, it's an azalea. Oh, Sid told me all about them. He loved azaleas.
It's beautiful, isn't it?
Oh. I'm going to put it right there by the door so that every time I look at it, it'll remind me of my first day of freedom.
Good idea. Well, I better be going.
Oh, thanks a lot, Mrs. M. Oh, Mrs. M, are you doing that pre-sentence thing on door?
Yes, I am. Why?
Oh, well, look after her, will you? Poor little kid. It wasn't her fault.
See what I can do.
She needs someone to look after her. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Time for smoke, OB.
Suit yourself.
Smoke-o, girls.
Yeah, all right. Come on, take a break.
Hey, my smoke glove?
No, thanks.
She's real screwy, if you ask me.
Well, no one did, so lay off.
Well, you lot obviously need more to do. It's about time you did a decent day's work. Come on, get on with it.
Cop her. Pushy pal, the prisoner's pet.
Mm. Kent, how'd you like to enjoy your own company in solitary?
No thanks, Mrs. Powell. I'm okay.
Smith, you're to report to Officer Parsons in the library.
Well, well, what do you know? It's finally arrived, eh?
Yes, and if I had my way, there'd be no such things as Braille projects. Still, with your record, it won't last.
I wouldn't bet on that.
Well, bye-bye, girls. I'll see you later.
Oh, but who's going to take over the press?
We can toss for it.
But Jude's in the office and you're going to be in the library.
Well, then you can do it if you like.
When you're not here, you mean.
Look, figure it out for yourself. I don't give a damn who operates the bloody thing.
Told you, Bea's gone soft. She doesn't care about anything.
G'day.
Oh, hello. Are you me postie?
No, that's right. Charlie Parsons at your service.
Oh. Good on you, Charlie. You got any letters?
Nah, not today. That's why I stopped, really. This house has been empty for some time, hasn't it?
Yeah, I just moved in today.
Well, you better let the post office know. Otherwise, they'll return letters to sender, you know.
Thanks, I'll do that.
That's a nice azalea you've got there. It's a good spot for it, too. They like a bit of shade.
Do you like gardens?
Oh, I love them. I've got some rhododendrons at home, prize ones. Would you like some cuttings?
Thanks, I would like that. I'm Lizzie. Lizzie Birdsworth.
Glad to meet you, Lizzie. Tell you what, I'll get in touch with the post office and let them know the house is occupied. Save your trip, eh?
Thank you.
All right, well, I better be pushing on, eh?
Bye, Charlie. Playing up, that's all.
Look, who's going to be top dog if Bee's pulling out?
Well, Bee's not pulling out. She may have gone a bit soft, but she's still top dog.
You reckon?
Yeah. Bee will be all right, you'll see.
Hope you're right.
Anyway, she's only going to be in the library 3 days a week and she can work the press the rest of the time, can't she?
Yeah.
And when Jude's here, she can work the press, so everything's all right.
Glad I'm to work it.
Yeah.
Burns. Interview room.
Have I got a visitor?
No, it's a welfare officer.
Well, I hope it's Mrs. Morris.
Well, you'll see. Kent, you can run the press.
Ah, oh, there she is.
The instructor will be here in a moment. Huh. I don't think you should attempt to use the machine without the qualified teacher.
Ah, don't worry. I know what I'm doing. I should do. I've been reading about this thing for days. There we go. Now, move carriage, head over paper. And how does it work?
See, blind people read with their fingers. See the bumps?
Yes, I see.
Oh, you wouldn't get many words to a page, would you? Whole book must weigh a ton.
I still don't think it's wise that you should use the machine until you have been trained.
If it makes you happy, I sit here and stare at a wall. Even that beats days on end in the laundry.
Thank you, Mrs. Clark.
Do you need me to stay?
No, no, I'll be fine, thanks.
Right, let me know when you're finished.
Right, sit down, Doreen. I've been asked to prepare a pre-sentence report on you, Doreen, so I just thought we'd have a little chat.
Well, there's nothing to say. You know all there is to know about me.
Yes, I know all the facts, Doreen, but I'm looking for something more.
You going to talk about Peter in that report?
Yes, yes, I probably will.
He's not going to get into any more trouble, is he?
No, no, of course not. I mean, he's not in trouble with the police. He just thought he was, that was all.
Yeah, well, just as long as it doesn't ruin things, because he's doing pretty good now, you know.
Yes, I know. He came to see me and I'm very impressed. But it's you I'm concerned about, Doreen.
I'm going to cop more time, aren't I?
Yes, well, it is likely. After all, escaping from custody as a trusted prisoner will not go down very well with the VJ.
Yeah, I know that.
If we can prove that you were of good behaviour before you went in and you're behaving yourself now, we may just get away with a concurrent sentence.
Oh, well, that wouldn't be so bad, because I have been good, not been in the pound or anything. You could tell him that.
Yes, I will. And, Doreen, when you see the VJ, please tell him the truth. If he can see that you've got a good attitude, he might just be a little bit more sympathetic. Well, that's all I've got to say. And please, Doreen, stay out of trouble.
Oh, don't worry, Mrs. Morris. I'll be straight as a die. Honest.
Hey!
15?
No.
God,
I'm not
giving you
money,
Mary.
Hey.
What did she say?
She said I could be all right, might get off with a concurrent.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
All right, Mayo, ladies. Burns.
Oh, that'll be from Lizzie.
Don't be ridiculous, she only left this morning.
Fisher.
Adler. Goldman. Where is Goldman?
Oh, I'll get her. Anything for me?
No, that's all.
Right, now listen carefully.
I'm not at all happy with the amount of work that's being done in the laundry. So from now on, I'm going to keep an eye on things. Anyone who isn't pulling a weight will be put on report. Hennessy, you'll be working the laundry after lunch.
But I can't, it's too dangerous.
You'll do as you're told. Letter, Goldman. Can I have a word with you?
She's ready to pop her cork at any minute.
Yeah.
I can't get into any more strife, though. Mrs. Morris says that I've got to be of good behaviour and then I'll be okay.
Well, you keep out of their road, then.
Yeah. God, look at her. She's going to kill Hennessy.
Hello? 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 Ah, oh, could have waited. Hello? Hello? Anyone there?
You awake, B?
Yeah.
You missing Lizzie too?
What do you reckon?
Oh, come on, Bea, what's eating you? You can tell me.
Nothing's the matter. I'm just sick and tired of your yabbering, that's all.
I'm a bit nervous, I suppose. I've got to see the VJ today.
Well, don't expect any sympathy from me. Your stupid effort cost us the attendance centre.
Is that why you're so stroppy?
No, it's not. So, for God's sake, just belt up.
Good morning, Lizzie.
G'day.
I brought you these cuttings. They're a wee bit small, but they'll take well.
Well, there's a hole made over there already.
Oh, but I like a wee bit less sun. I would put them more in the shade if I were you.
Shame to waste a good hole.
Oh, I'll be pushing on then. Spread the good news, eh? We'll see you.
I don't reckon she'll do anything while the screws are still here.
Don't you believe it? I reckon she could go at any time.
Oh, aren't they hard little workers? Goldman, you can do better than that. Come on, what sort of work is this? Start them again and fold them properly. What are you looking at, Burns? Let's see how good you are at the press.
I am good at it, Mrs. Powell. Sometimes I get stuck.
No excuses, just show me.
Stuck now, see? Ah, oh, she's tugging! Get her off!
Hi, Coleman!
Look, she just attacked me. You weren't looking. She's gonna kill me.
That's enough of that, Hennessy. Now get back to work.
You can't leave me in here with her. She'll do it again.
I wouldn't worry about that. Goldman looks like becoming a permanent resident in solitary. And I'd be careful if I were you, or you might join her.
You stinking bitch!
Cut that out, Goldman. Get her out of here. Well? Work. Hennessy, fix the sheets.
Yes, Mrs. Powell.
Mrs. Powell?
Just wait over there.
What's happening?
She's on her way back to solitary.
What for?
Fight in the laundry.
Who with?
Oh, a friend, Hennessy.
I knew it. Those two shouldn't be in the same block.
Well, I fought it. But no, Mr. Fletcher doesn't want to see the other blocks overloaded. I consider we're all at risk while this goes on. And I'm quite relieved to have an excuse to be rid of one of them.
Look, I've got to see Gorman at some point. I may as well be now.
Oh, Meg, I doubt whether you'll get much out of her. I'd say she was pretty disturbed.
We'll see.
Right, Gorman. Now, you're going to see a lot more of this cell unless you pull yourself together. You've got 24 hours to think about it. Mrs. Morris wants to speak with you. Officer Barfield will stay with you in case there's any trouble.
Well, I'd prefer to be alone.
Up to you.
Thanks.
Wait outside, but keep the door open.
Could I stay a minute? This can't go on, you know.
What?
You've got to face reality. Look, you could be here in prison for a long time.
Don't you think I know that?
But you have to come to terms with it.
And how do you expect me to do that?
Look, I know it's not easy, but if you keep getting into trouble, you only make life more and more difficult for yourself.
Well, that's a great little speech, but I'm not the meek and mild type. Or didn't you realise that on the fire escape?
Look, I'll say what I think, and you can take it or leave it. Now, I've been here a long time, and I know what it's like. There are those that make a go of being here, and there are those that go under. Now, I think you've got to have a far more positive attitude. Forget Andrea Hennessy and find something else to occupy your mind.
How can I forget her when I have to work and eat in the same place?
Yes, well, I think we'll see about getting that changed. Would that help?
I suppose so.
You were studying before, weren't you?
Yeah, economics.
Would you like to go on with it?
What, in here?
Well, it could be arranged.
What's the point?
It'll give you something to do. Something positive for when you get out. Right. Well, you think about it. And you let me know.
Okay. Oh, thanks for coming.
I can understand your reasons for escaping, Burns, but I can't condone them. The fact that you were one of a small group of privileged prisoners working on the outside of the prison makes it worse, in my opinion. I asked your welfare officer to give me a report, and I must say she seems pleased with your progress on the whole. Also, I've heard your side of things, and I believe you've told me the truth. Consequently, I've made a decision. I acknowledge the suggestion from Mrs. Morris's report referring to a concurrent sentence, and I accept your behaviour as being good. But you did betray a trust, and I must make an example of you. I sentence you to 2 years for escaping from legal custody, 18 months to be served concurrently.
Oh, but that means 6 more months.
How'd it go?
6 months.
6 months?
Yeah, well, I got 2 years, but 18 months is concurrent.
Then I say you got off lightly.
It's not the way I see it.
Well, at least I hope you've learnt your lesson.
Oh, what lesson could I learn from staying in this rotten place another 6 months?
Well, maybe you should take a hint from your mates. Smith and Bryant both seem to be doing something worthwhile.
Well, what could I do?
Well, I don't know. But if you give it a bit of thought, you might come up with an idea or two. If you do, you let me know.
You mean I could do a project or something?
Well, yeah, if you like. Anyway, you think about it.
Yeah, all right, I will.
Inside and sit down. Hi. Welcome to the mystery tour. Relax. Plenty more locked doors where we're going. And people to push you around. Here we go. Goodbye to the real world for a while. Oh, it's not that bad. Have you been to prison before? On and off. Not this one, though. Went to Barnhurst last time. What was it like? Not like home, I've got to admit. But it wasn't too bad. What did you... why were you in there? Little misdemeanors. A couple of cops who didn't see things my way. Nothing big. Not like this one, anyway.
This one?
Same as you. Anyway, my name's Sandy. I reckon we'll be seeing a bit of each other for a while. We might as well be mates. Smoke?
No, thanks, I don't.
Quite right. Don't you grow. Well. Wentworth. Here we come.
These are to be filed, right? And I want those as soon as possible.
Can I have a word with you, please, Miss Conway?
Of course.
We have two new arrivals this morning, both long-termers. They can go straight into H block. Can you handle the proceedings?
Oh, I imagine so. Who are they?
Well, there's Kate Peterson, murder, and Sandra Edwards, murder as well.
Maybe a murderous morning.
Hope you don't mean that literally. You still write for today?
Of course.
Good. I'll pick you up about 7:30. Do you like Indian food?
Oh, not all that much. I'm a bit conservative when it comes to what I eat.
Good. I know just the place.
I suppose the only contact you ever had with the police was a driver's license, eh?
Not quite. If I ever got lost, I'd always ask a friendly policeman.
Friendly? Hard to imagine. Are you going to appeal?
There's no point. What would I appeal against? You seem to know a lot about me.
I like to keep in touch. I've read the papers. Sounds like you've got a pretty reasonable sort of trial, but I'll appeal just the same.
Maybe I could, but really I'm in no condition to even think about that yet. I can't even begin to accept what's happening.
You'll get used to it.
You're so calm about it all.
Why not? What's the point in getting myself in a knot? I did what I did. And that's it.
You're convicted of murder too.
Guilty as charged.
You don't sort of look like a murderer.
You reckon I don't look like a murderer?
Oh, yes, I see what you mean.
I tell you something. There are two sorts of people doing time. The goodies and the baddies. That's the difference between you and me.
How do you mean?
Well, I'm a crim. A professional. But you're a doctor who made a mistake.
Yes, I certainly did.
This is the old Wentworth slammer, eh?
It's enough of that. You're in prison now and you'll behave accordingly.
Yes, sir.
Oh, come on you. You're not out for a Sunday stroll. Come this way.
I bet she's new. You can always tell when they lay all that crap on you. She's probably more scared than you are.
She couldn't be. I'm scared stiff.
Come on, you two. You stand on the line and you over there. Your name is Catherine Elaine Peterson?
Yes.
You have been charged and convicted of murder. You've been sentenced to 15 years jail to serve a minimum of 12, is that correct?
Yes.
Right, go to the counter, remove all jewelry and your watch. Officer Perry will take your belongings and you'll sign for them. Your name is Sandra Edwards?
Who?
Sandra Edwards.
No, that's not me. That should say Janine Scott, immoral earnings in 3 weeks. I'll tell you what, if this chick got less than 3 weeks, I'll be her if you like.
Get on the line. These papers correct?
As far as I know.
Then someone's made a mistake. Look, I better check at the City Watch House. They'll be able to tell me.
Better go and get Mr. Fletcher. I see. Edwards, yeah. Good, well, thank you very much.
He's trouble. He looks like the boss.
Boss?
All right, tell me the story in detail.
The Watch House had a Janine Scott on a 3-week sentence for immoral earnings, but she should be on her way to Barnhurst. Edwards and Peterson are coming here, according to their records.
All right, Edwards, Peterson, on your feet.
Did I hear you say I was meant to go to Barnhurst? Oh, they did get things mixed up, didn't they? But don't worry. I'll catch a taxi if you like.
You stay right where you were.
They'll soon work it out. If you keep going, you'll get into trouble.
Yeah, well, I suppose I've had my fun. Mr. Fletcher, isn't it?
That's right.
I suppose I'd better own up.
I thought so. I don't care who you think you are, Edwards. In here, you're just another prisoner. I'm here to make sure that you understand that. All right?
Yes, Mr. Fletcher.
Good. Carry on, please, Miss Conway.
Get on that line. Beds to be made by morning muster. If they're not neat, they will be made again. All personal items to be kept tidy at all times.
What's that for?
End of work. There's a 15-minute break, then muster and lunch.
Where do we go for lunch?
You'll be shown. In the meantime, get on with your beds.
Slow down, she's gone. Can't imagine why anyone would want to work here.
Desperation. Or they're just bent that way.
I'm glad we're in together. At least I'll have someone to talk to.
Suits me, too. If I get appendicitis in the middle of the night, you can operate on the spot.
Might as well forget about medicine. By the time I get out of here, I won't be of any use to anyone.
You never know. They might put you to work in the prison hospital.
Hardly. I'm in for murder, remember?
Nah, you're a oncer. They'll know that. Hello. Can I come in?
Sure.
I'm Judy Bryant. You got yourself a good job in the office. You must be a trustee.
Yeah, I guess so.
Been in long?
Long enough.
Hey, I know who you are. You're the chick that made the tapes when you were on the run. Oh, I'm glad to know you.
Yeah, well, it was a long time ago. It didn't do any good either.
Oh, I'm Sandy. This is Kate.
Sandy.
Hello.
Now, Kate, you're a doctor, aren't you?
I used to be.
Yeah. Listen, it's almost muster. Why don't you come down the rec room and meet the girls?
Why not? Coming?
Oh, I don't know.
Oh, come on. You've got to get used to it sometime.
All right.
No, I wouldn't mind being an archy thingy, you know, inventing new buildings.
Architect.
Yeah, that's it. I'd be real easy. And those blokes make squillions. Hey, look, I've done one already.
Yeah, it's pretty weak, I reckon. Looks like you'll have to start again, Mouse. Oh, June, it looks like you're going to have to put up with me a bit longer.
I'd like you to meet Kate and Mrs. Sandy. Hello. You know what? Sandy really made Fletch and Conway sit up and take notice. You're not going to believe what she did. When they brought her in, she said she was someone else. Conway was nearly in tears. They really fell for it.
G'day, girls.
Hi.
Hello. Not a bad little setup you got here.
Yeah, well, I'd like to meet Doreen. That's Cheryl and Mouse, Tammy, Nola, Lil, Mary and Tina.
Don't you want to know what I got?
Yeah, I already heard. You got 6 months, huh?
I didn't get 6 months. I got 2 years and 18 months as concurrent.
I'm facing 15 years. That'll teach you to be a bad girl.
Hey, who's in the top slot around here?
Oh, B. Smith.
Oh, yeah. I've heard of her. Where is she?
Well, right now she's working the Braille machine in the library, but usually she works in the laundry.
Yeah, and I work the press when she's away.
Is that right? Well, I'm looking forward to meeting her.
Believe you got another 6 months?
Yeah.
Sorry to hear it.
Well, it keeps you in work, doesn't it?
Have you thought any more about Mr. Fletcher's offer?
Bit.
Any ideas?
Oh, I thought I might do some artwork.
Is that what you were doing when I came in?
Oh, yeah, just a drawing.
Can I have a look?
It's nothing much.
I'd be really interested to have a look at it. It's not bad.
Can you tell who it is?
Well, I don't think Bea'd be flattered, but there's no doubt about it.
Didn't go much for artwork. Just a bit of fancy writing on checks, you know?
Have you had a look at the art books in the library?
Yeah, but there wasn't much in them. All good pictures had got ripped out.
I've got a couple of art books at home. You could have a look at them if you wanted to.
Well, that'd be great.
Well, I think you've got some talent.
Yeah?
Yeah. And I think you could do very well if you wanted to work at it.
You reckon it could be my project?
Possibly.
And I wouldn't have to work in the laundry?
Well, we'll see. I think you should get a folio together first.
Oh, yeah, I'll do that. Then Mr. Fletcher can see what I can do.
Yeah. Well, I'll bring those books in tomorrow.
Oh, thanks, Miss Conway.
Get back to the laundry, Dory.
Yeah, righto. See you later.
Well, for present food, it'll do the job.
I thought it was awful. Overcooked, over-salted. How on earth are we going to eat that for the next...
Oh, it's not that bad. You'll get the hang of it.
I suppose so.
I wonder where Bea Smith got to.
Yeah, Dorian said she had a headache, stayed in her cell.
Yeah, it was a bit strange. Mari Winter at Barnhurst told me all about her. I thought she'd be checking us out straight away. I reckon something's brewing.
What do you mean?
I don't know. Just had that feeling. We could do worse, you know. 3 meals a day, good company, nice little lounge down the corridor. Not bad at all.
God, I wish I could feel like that. I still can't believe I'm in here, that I can't just get up and walk home.
That'll wear off. This'll feel like home after a while.
God, I hope not. You know, sometimes when I close my eyes, I can see my son.
What's his name?
Jerry. He's 3. I've loved 2 people in my life, and I've lost both of them.
The bloke you killed?
No. That was Conrad. I'm talking about my husband, Jerry. He was killed in a car crash. I didn't think I could go on. Then my baby was born, and I just lived for him.
Then this Conrad turned up.
Yes. Oh, I suppose I wanted somebody to share things with. I was lonely. If only I'd known what he really was. When I knew for certain he was going to kill my little boy, what else could I have done?
I would have done the same. Any man that tries to kill a little kid like that doesn't deserve to live.
I know, but look at me now, Amy. What good has it done me?
Listen, Kate. It may sound like corny advice, but I've been around. And I know what a place like this can do to your mind. You've got to forget all that. We're in here for a long one. You might as well make the most of it.
Yes, I know. It's just hard to accept, that's all.
You'll make it. We start work in the laundry tomorrow. I reckon there'll be plenty to keep us busy.
Yes.
Seems a pity to talk about the prison in a place like this.
Yes, I know what you mean. I really like the idea of leaving the prison behind once you walk through the gates, but that doesn't mean to say I can't talk about it out of hours.
Well, I wonder if I can keep it up. So much has happened already.
Well, it's always hard when you first go in. There are a lot of situations you just don't find in any other job.
I know.
Well, from what I've observed, you seem to be adapting quicker than most. I think you'll make a very good officer.
I hope so.
Peterson, outside.
Pardon?
You wanted in the governor's office? No.
What for?
Well, never mind what for. You come with me.
Oh, I'm not going like this. Can't it wait until I'm ready?
When you are ordered to do something, Peterson, you do it. Now move.
I believe I have a perfect right to get dressed first.
I don't know who you think you are or why you think you should be treated any differently from anyone else, but I'll explain it to you once. In here, you are a prisoner, and as such, you will do what you are told, when you are told, and if you do not, you will be punished.
You mean I've no right to know why I'm being summoned?
Do I have to drag you out?
All right. I don't think you have any right to treat me like an animal.
Move it, you two. And she refused to obey the order to move.
I see. These are very serious charges, Peterson. What do you got to say for yourself?
Well, I don't believe I did anything wrong. I simply objected to being brought in here half-dressed, and I wanted to know why I was required. It's only basic courtesy.
I'm afraid you won't find much courtesy around here.
Well, I expect at least to be treated like a normal person.
I'm afraid you're going to have to get used to a rather different set of rules in here, Peterson.
You mean I'm not permitted to know anything unless an officer chooses to tell me?
You'll be told what's considered necessary. Otherwise, you just have to accept things the way they are.
I see.
Right, well, I'll let it go this time.
But if it happens again,
you'll go and report. Now, what I wanted to talk to you about was your prison work. From reading your file, it's obvious that we'd be wasting your abilities in the laundry.
I don't want special treatment.
Well, we could certainly use your training. We don't have a medical officer at the moment.
Mr. Fletcher, what I have just been through, including this morning, makes me realize that I am no different from any of the other unfortunate women in here. If I'm to be accepted as one of them, I would like to be treated as such.
I see. Well, I don't want to push you into anything. Why don't you think about it? Let me know if you change your mind.
May I go now?
Yes, of course. If you need anything, just let me know.
I will. Thank you, Mr. Fletcher.
Wait outside, Peterson. Why did you let her off?
It's early days yet. She needs time to settle in.
Well, what do you think the other women are going to think when they see her getting away scot-free?
I don't think they're going to find out.
Well, I'm going to look very silly if they do.
No, I don't think so. And I don't think she'll do it again.
I'm not so sure.
Well, I am. Believe me, I know what I'm doing. And what I said to you last night still goes. I think you're doing a great job. All you need is a bit more experience.
She may be new, but she's not soft. She'll stick up for her rights.
Yeah, she certainly told a discount screwer to get off.
Yeah, Fletcher's not going to do anything about her, though. He'll probably have her working in the hospital.
Well, that's good. We ought to have our own doctor.
Oh, I don't know. She's just a prisoner to them. She'll have access to dope, knives, alcohol, all that kind of stuff. I don't think they'll go that far. Well, she didn't get sent to the pound anyway.
She looks okay to me.
How come you're so worried about her?
I'm not worried about her. I just like the way she stands up for herself.
What happened?
Nothing much.
Did you do a deal with Fletch? He likes your sort.
It was a misunderstanding, that's all.
How come you knocked off that bloke?
Lay off, will you?
He was a threat to my child. He could have killed him.
Oh. How come you couldn't prove that in court?
What is this? Are you planning to join the cops? Why don't you mind your own business?
What's it to you?
You better beat it while you're in front.
Are you threatening me?
Put it this way, my tubby little friend. I'm in here for murder, but that's only the one they got me on. I could always add one more.
Big deal.
Doreen, I brought you these.
Oh, they're great. I'll look after them real well, I promise.
Have you thought of entering the Wentworth and District Art Exhibition?
Me?
Well, why not? It's open to everyone.
Oh, I'm not good enough.
Well, I think you could be if you put your mind to it.
Go in an exhibition? Is there a prize?
Quite a few for different categories.
Oh, I'd like to win a prize. I've never won a prize in my whole life.
Well, why don't you talk to Mr. Fletcher and see if he can arrange materials in time for you to work?
Oh, you little ripper. Thanks, Miss Conway.
You're welcome. Now, you better put those away and get down to the laundry.
Oh, yeah, sure thing.
So, this is a sweatshop, eh? Hell, it looks like a museum.
Well, I hate to tell you this, honey, but that's been said before.
Just my luck.
Bea Smith here today?
No, she'd be working in the library.
Right. Then I think I'll have a go at the press.
Oh, I always work the press, you see.
Hey, guess what?
You can have a go some other time.
Jude's on the press because Bea's away. And when Jude's in the office, it's me.
Look, why don't you swap around? Take it in turns. It could make things more interesting.
Good idea. Come on, what's the hold-up?
Sandy, it's mine.
Oh, come off it. What's so special about this old thing anyway?
Of course, if you want to fight me for it, I'll be in that too.
Now, who's first?
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then.